Hello student, this is Ashish Vegarwa from Electrical Department. Today we will learn thyristor commutation in the subject power electronics. Let's move to the content of this topic. In this topic we will learn classification of commutation, what do you mean by commutation, comparison between natural commutation and forced commutation. And last we will see class A commutation. Let's see what are the classification of commutation. Commutation can be classified by two ways, that is natural commutation and forced commutation. In forced commutation having different types, that is class A commutation, it is self-commutated by resonating load. Class B commutation, it is self-commutated by LC circuit. Class C commutation, it is a complementary commutation. Class D commutation, it is a impulse commutation. Class E commutation, it is external pulse commutation. It means we have to provide external pulse to turn off the SCR. And last we will see class F commutation, which is a natural commutation. It is a line commutation. Let's see what is the exact meaning of commutation. The process to turn off the SCR is defined as commutation. The process to turn off the SCR is defined as commutation. SCR is device which can be turned on or turned off by providing gate pulse. On AC supply, it will be turned off automatically. But on DC supply, we have to provide some external reverse voltage across the SCR such that it will be turned off. So commutation is a process by which we can turn off the SCR manually or forcefully. In all the commutation technique, a reverse voltage is applied across the thyristor during turn-off process. By turning off the thyristor, we bring it from the forward conducting to the forward blocking mode. In forward conducting mode, it can conduct the current. But in forward blocking mode, it can only conduct the current amount of leakage current. There are two conditions which are need to be satisfied to turn off the SCR. The first condition is value of anode current is less than holding current such that SCR can be turned off. And the second condition is that we have to provide reverse voltage across the SCR for sufficient time duration such that it will be recover its blocking state. There are two methods by which we can turn off the SCR, that is natural commutation and forced commutation. First let's see natural commutation. In a AC circuit, as the current always passes through the zero for every cycle. So this is a circuit diagram in which we have connected one SCR in series with the load and we have supplied AC supply, that is V is equal to Vm into sin omega t. So this is the input waveform of AC supply. So it is a sinusoidal in nature. It means it having one positive half cycle and second having one negative half cycle. So during starting, value of supply is zero. After that it will try to increase. It will become maximum. Again it will become zero. Again it will increase in reverse direction. And again it will come back to the zero point. So during one cycle, it will cross the two zero point. As the current passes through the natural zero, the reverse voltage will may appear across the device. After that, SCR will be turned off immediately. Thus this process is called the natural commutation. No external pulse is required for this purpose. And this method is only applicable for AC supply. It means it cannot work on DC supply. We have to use only and only AC supply to provide the natural commutation. Let's see next commutation, that is forced commutation. To turn off the thyristor, the forward anode current should be brought to zero for sufficient time duration to allow the removal of charge carriers. In case of DC circuit, the forward current should be forced to zero. Suppose we have DC circuit, then forward current we have to force to zero by providing some external pulse. And circuit which provides external pulse is called the forced commutation circuit. And this process, that's why it is called the forced commutation. In this process also we have to reduce anode current of SCR below the holding current such that SCR will be turned off. It requires so many components like R, L, C, etc. And this component is called the commutating components. Let's see the difference in between natural commutation and forced commutation. The first difference is that natural commutation requires AC supply, whereas forced commutation will be work on DC or maybe on AC. Second is external component are not required in case of natural commutation, whereas in forced commutation external component maybe R, L, C, etc. are required. Natural commutation used in control rectifier and AC voltage controller, whereas the forced commutation used in chopper circuit, inverter, etc. Fourth one is SCR turn off due to negative supply voltage in case of natural commutation. In case of forced commutation, ACR will be turned off by reducing anode current less than holding current or by applying reverse voltage. Fifth one is, in case of natural commutation, there is no power loss take place during commutation, whereas in forced commutation, there is power loss in the R component. Natural commutation having no cost or maybe zero cost, whereas in forced commutation having significant cost. Let's see the first commutation circuit. That is a class A commutation. Also, it is called the self-commutated by resonating load. Why resonating? Because it requires RLC component. And this RLC component, a resonating component. That's why it is called the RLC resonating load. So, this is a circuit diagram of class A commutation circuit. As per this diagram, we have connected one SCR in series with one inductor, one capacitor, and across we have connected one load, that is R. And here we have provided one AC supply. And this class A commutation is forced commutation circuit. Class A commutation is widely used in case of thyristor commutation technique. If the thyristor is triggered or turned on, the anode current will flow and it will charge this capacitor. So upper plate of capacitor will be positive, and this LNC component will form under damped circuit. So waveform of this circuit will decay continuously. As per this diagram, if we trigger this SCR, then anode current will flow from the supply to the SCR, to the inductor and this capacitor C. So upper plate of this capacitor will going to charge as a positive. When the upper plate of this capacitor will charge fully is equal to the supply voltage, at that time this SCR will going to face reverse voltage across it. Cathode terminal of the SCR will be greater than anode terminal of the SCR, so such that this SCR will be going to turn off by providing some reverse voltage due to this capacitor. As of this SCR will be turned off, but this capacitor having some charge, so this charging capacitor will be discharged through this load. Hence we have to select value of this component, that is LNC, such that the SCR will be turned off at the peak time, at the peak value of the sine wave. This way we can turn off this SCR by providing reverse voltage across the SCR by using this capacitor. Time required to switch off this SCR will be depend upon the resonance frequency, and this resonance frequency is also depends on the value of this R, L and C component. And this method is reliable, simple and used for very high frequency application greater than 1000 hertz. Let's see the question for assignment. The first one is, classify different types of commutation. Next is, explain class A commutation. And the last one is, compare natural commutation and forced commutation. Thank you.
If you like this video, please subscribe and like our YouTube channel LJB Electrical. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to get latest video update first.